this video, let us solve some problems on equivalent resistance. So here I have taken two problems. Now we have to find RAB, that is the equivalent resistance between the terminals A and B. So in this case, you can consider this point as A and this point as B. So from A to B, if I consider, you will be having these two in series, that is 15 ohm and 6 ohm are in series, 10 ohm and 4 ohm are in series. So that will be 21 ohm and here it will be 14 ohms. So I will redraw this. I will consider two points now between which I have to find the equivalent terminals. See, between A and B I have two resistors connected like this, and also we have another path for the current to flow, that is 10 ohm and 4 ohms. Here it is 15 and 6. So since these two resistors are in series, we can write this as 21 ohms, which is in parallel with 14 ohms. So what will be your RAB? RAB is nothing but it is 21 ohm in parallel with 14 ohm. So you know the formula for the parallel combination, that is when you have two resistors in parallel, that will be R1 divided by R1 plus R2. So 21 into 14 divided by 21 plus 14, that is equal to 35. 21 into 14, you know 7 3s are 21, 7 5s are your 35. Okay, so it will be equal to 42 divided by 5, which is nothing but it is 8.4 ohm. So your equivalent resistance will be equal to 8.4 ohm. So now let us consider this figure. Here you have, see, the terminals A and B. Okay, so if this is the path, see here, if the current is flowing, that means it can divide like this, right? Okay, but what happens? The current can flow through the same path, that is one path. That means 5 ohm and 5 ohm will be in series. So that becomes 10 ohm. But the current divides here, so this and this will be obviously in parallel. Okay, so first this one will be in series. So what, after doing that series combination, you will get it like this, almost like this. Okay, so it is 10 ohm, this is 10 ohm, this is 10 and this is 5 ohms. So this is A and this is B. Now you can see 10 ohm and 10 ohm, these are in parallel. So when two same resistors, means when two resistors of equal resistance value are connected in parallel, then it will be divided by 2, right? You know R equivalent will be equal to R divided by N, where N number of resistors with equal resistance are connected in parallel. So here we will be getting 5, 10 divided by 2, that is equal to 5 ohms. Okay, so this is 5 ohms. Now you can see these two are in series now, because the current, it can flow like this. Okay, so these two are in series. So 5 plus 5, that will be equal to 10. Okay, so this point and this point. Okay, that means you can write it as 10 ohms. Now you can see between these two terminals, you have two resistors, that is equal resistors connected in parallel. So the value of RAB, that will be equal to 10 divided by 2, that is equal to 5 ohms. Okay, so let us take a few more problems and solve it. Now to find the equivalent resistance between A and B. Ohm, this is 8 ohms and this is the point B, this is the point A, this is 12 ohms. Okay, and here okay, you have to find the equivalent resistance between these two terminals A and B. In this case, you can consider, see, this is directly connected, means these two are the common nodes, so I can name this as A. And this is, there is no resistor in between, a wire is connected, so that will be B. Okay, so now we will consider two points A and B here. Okay, see, between A and B, one is we have 12 ohms, right? We have 12 ohms. Between A and B, we have 6 ohms. Between A and B, we also have 8 ohms. So, all these are in parallel. Okay, so R1 by R equivalent, that will be equal to 1 by 12 plus 1 by 6 plus 1 by 8. Okay, now you can take the LCM of this. Okay, I will take 1 by 2 outside. It will be 1 by 6 plus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 4. Taking the LCM of 4, 3 and 6. Okay, you have 4, 3 is a 12. Okay, so the LCM is 12 here in this case. So, 2 plus 4 plus 3. Okay, so this will be 6 plus 3, 9 divided by 24. That is 1 by R equivalent. So, R equivalent will be equal to 24 divided by 9. So, you know 3, 3 is a 9, 3, 8 is a 24. So, R equivalent will be equal to 8 by 3 ohms. So, you know the combination. So, for parallel, you have 1 by R equivalent that is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3 and so on till 1 by Rn. So, this is for the parallel combination. Now, let us take another problem. So you have A here, this is R1, R2, then you have R3. Here you have a source which is connected to this point. This is B and this is A. Okay, and these two points are connected like this. So now you have to find RAB in this case. Okay, you have to find RAB in this case. See, here there is no resistor in between. So, this point and this point I can consider as C. If there was a resistor, then this would be C, this would be D. But here we do not have any resistor. These are common nodes now. So, I will consider that as C. Okay. So, So, in between A and C, B and C, this is again B and C. That means in between B and C, you have two resistors, R2 and R3. Okay, this is B and C, this is also B and C, means they will be in parallel. Okay, so R2 and R3. Then you have A point, here you have R1. Okay, then you have a voltage source here. So, you can consider this parallel means you have formula R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So, R2 R3 divided by R2 plus R3. This combination is in series with the resistor R1. So, I can write it as plus R1. This is your equivalent resistance, that is RAB. This will be in parallel, which is in series with R1. Why in parallel? Because this is directly connected. Okay. So, there is no resistor in between. So, I can name that two nodes as C. Okay. Now, we can see in between B and C, we have two resistors. So, in between terminals, if we are having two resistors, then that will be obviously in parallel combination, because series means if you have two resistors in series, if I consider this as A, this as B and this is C, okay, you can see like this. But parallel means, see, you will have two nodes here, A and B, okay, and both the resistors will be having the same terminals. Here also both the resistors are having the same terminals. Okay, now let us take another problem. This is a point A. This is C. This is D. This is B. Here we have another resistor. This is E. F. These points will be connected directly. So, all the resistance value will be R now. All the resistors have the same resistance value R. Now, we have to find RAB in this case. So, it looks like a bit complicated, but it's very easy. See, because you know C and D, okay, they are directly connected, right? This is a direct connection between C and D. That means we can consider C and D as same, okay? They will be having same potential, we can consider. This also E and F, they are directly connected. So F or E, it is also E or F, okay? So we can consider E and F, C and D, okay? So now we have to consider A. Next, we will consider point CD. Then we will consider point EF. Then we will have a point B. Okay. So from A to D, we have one resistor. From A to C, we have another resistor. Okay. Then we have from D to F. D to F means this one, we have one resistor. C to E, we have another resistor. Then C to F, we have two resistors. So since this is in series, we can consider it as 2R. Here also we have two resistors in series, that is between D and E. So this also can be considered as 2R. Now from E to B, we have one resistor. And from F to B, we have another resistor. Okay. And in between A and B, we have two resistors, that is in series. We can consider that as 2R because it is in series. These two are in series, that is in between A and B. So I will write it here. Now this is the parallel combination. So they have equal resistance value. So I can directly write this as R divided by 2. Okay. So here we have two equal resistors, R by 2. Then we have two equal resistors 2R. So that equivalent resistance of two 2Rs will be equal to R. So R by 2 will be in parallel with R. So you can write this as R by 2 into R divided by R by 2 plus R. So this can also be written as 3R by 2. So it is R by 3. It is R by 3. So this is equivalent resistance will be R by 3. This also both will be having same resistance value R and R. So this will be R divided by 2. Okay, R divided by 2. So now all these are in series. That means R by 2 plus R by 3 plus R by 2. This combination is in parallel with 2R resistor. 2R. So this R by 2, R by 2 is R. R plus R by 3, that will be equal to 4R by 3. That is in parallel with 2R. Okay, that is in parallel with 2R. Now simplify it. You have 4R by 3 into 2R by 4R by 3 plus 2R. So this is equal to 4R by 3 into 2R divided by, this is 6 plus 4, that is 10R divided by 3, cancel out 5. So that will be equal to 4R divided by 5. This will be your equivalent resistance. Just remember, you have to see, like, if the potentials are connected directly, then those nodes can be considered as the common nodes. So here C and D, E and F will be common nodes. So we have to see from A to B, like, which points are connected to what. Means in between A and C and A and D, we have two resistors. But C and D means D is C, C is D. So that means these two resistors are in parallel. And in between A and B, we have two resistors. That means two resistors are in series, which will be written here. Okay, in between A and B only, this will be the combinations, that is CD, EF, then from EF to B. Okay, so we will solve this parallel combinations first, and then all these parallel combinations are in series. So we will add those. Okay, we will add those. And whatever the resultant will be there, that will be obviously in parallel with this 2R resistance because they both are having the same terminals, same nodes. So that will be in parallel with 2R. So after solving this, we will be getting the answer 4R divided by 5. In this figure, we have to find the equivalent resistance between A and B. So here you can see this is in series combination. Okay, they are connected to two different nodes. Okay, and there is only one path. If the current is flowing, it will be having only one path. So 1 plus 1, that will be 2 ohms. Okay, so it will be like this: 2 ohms, 6 ohms. Okay, and first I will redraw this. See, this is the point C. This is point C. There is no resistors in between, so I can consider all this as C points. This as E D. This as E. Okay, so we can see this is C. So E to C we have 3 ohms here. Okay, E to C we have another resistor that is 6 ohms. Then E to D we have resistor 2 ohm. D to C we have 2 resistor. One is 3 ohm, another one is 6 ohm, which will be in parallel. Then this also will be now in parallel, that is 2 ohms. Okay, so this is a parallel combination. So 3 into 6 divided by 3 plus 6. So obviously this will be equal to 2 ohms, and here these two will be equal to 2 ohms. And 2 ohms is in parallel with 2 ohm. So 2 divided by 2, that will be equal to 1. So this will be 1 ohm. So this combination, it will lead in 1 ohm. So we can write this now. So this is 2 ohms. This is 0.8. This is 1 ohm. We have 2 ohms here. And this is 1 ohm. And now you can see this 2 ohm and 1 ohm will be in series, right? This is series. So 2 plus 1, 3 ohms. So we can replace this now by 3 ohms. 2 and 3 ohms are in parallel. So this will be 2 into 3 divided by 5. That is nothing but 6 by 5. So now after simplifying, we got here it is 0.8. This is 6 by 5, which is nothing but 1.2. This is 1 ohms. So now these are in series, right, between the terminals A and B. So we can 1 plus 0.8 plus 1.2. So that will be obviously 3 ohms. So RAB, that is equal to 3 ohms.